Shalom. Kol halayim la, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakwadash. Double honors to the elder apostles, the elders of Great Millstone as GMS. Peace and blessing to the Akim and a few Akwath across the four winds. This is your brother Bartholomew from Great Millstone, Houston, coming to you with a quick lesson. Now, I saw this online and I took a screenshot of it. It's the evolution of war. So you have a rock, a spear. You have a bow and arrow, you have a bullet, then you have a broken arrow, which is a thermonuclear ICBM missile. You have a syringe that's filled with the serpent juice, which is the big poking. Then you have the CBDCs, which is the central bank digital currency, which is gonna ultimately lead to the microkaragma, you know, which is the mark of the, you know, the beast in Revelation 13 and 16. So all roads lead to the microkaragma, that grain of rice that's going to go into your skin so that you can buy or sell. So I just wanted to kind of go in on, you know, this cunning hunter, which is Esau Edom. You know, Esau in the Hebrew is Ashashia, which means wasted away is he. And Edom, it just goes into being red. And then, so you have these different levels of war, you know, throughout history. But, you know, I just kind of wanted to bring out a few precepts on that. I'm going to start in Genesis. The point is in 27, but I'm going to start up in Genesis chapter 25, verse 21. And Isaac entreated the Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah for his wife because she was barren. And the Lord was entreated of him, and Rebekah his wife conceived. And the children struggled together within her, and she said, if it be so, why am I thus? And she went to inquire of the Lord Yahweh. And the Lord Yahweh said unto her, two nations are in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels. So that goes to show you the Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah deals with separation. So we are separate. We are actually polar opposites, you know, from the self-proclaimed white man, which is Esau Edom. And then you have Jake, which is short for Jacob, whose name was changed to Israel, which is the Israelites, which are the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. So we've been separated. You know, it's two different people, two manner of people. And the one people shall be stronger than the other. The Israelites are stronger. Like, we're better than them pretty much in everything except wickedness, even though our people, you know, are the salt of the earth. You know, when they dwell in wickedness, you know, they can go overboard, so they can overtake them. But the wicked is Esau Edom. You know, you have three classifications of people. You have the sons of men, which is the heathen nations. You have the sons of God, which is the Israelites. And then ultimately, you have the sons of the wicked, which is Esau Edom. And the elder shall serve the younger. And it's going to go into, you know, the elder being Esau Edom. You know, he came out first. And then Jacob, or Yaquab, you know, he's a supplanter. That's what Yaquab means in the Hebrew. He came out second, holding the heel of Esau Edom. Just going to show you that we're pulling down strongholds, you know, pulling down Esau Edom out of his captivity. I think that's Daniel 7 and 18. The saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom. Genesis 25 and 24. And when her days to be delivered were fulfilled, behold, there were twins in her womb. So our twin brother, you know, our closest of kin are the Edomites. You know, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Our close, you know, brother is Esau Edom, but he's still polar opposite to us. Genesis 25 and 25. And the first came out red, which, you know, when you go into to Edom, the word means red, all over like a hairy garment. And they called his name Esau, you know, Ashashia, which he wasted away as he, you know, his pigmentation. He doesn't have any melanin. And, you know, Caucasians are typically hairy people, you know, even from birth or even as adults, you know, they're just hairy people. You know, look at the cavemen. Pretty much, you know, cave dweller, which is what Caucasian means. Genesis 25 and verse 26. And after that came his brother out, and he took hold of Esau's heel. So it didn't go into what Jacob looked like. You know, his name was changed to Israel, which goes to show you that we're naturally a melanated people. And his name was called Jacob, or Yaquah, which is a supplanter. And then even on the King James Online, it goes into heel holder, you know, pulling down strongholds. And Isaac was 80 years old when she buried them. A score is 20, so 80, he was 60 years old. But here's the main point that I wanted to get. And the boys grew, and Esau was a cunning hunter, a man of the field, and Jacob was a plain man dwelling in tents. So, you know, Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you know, we're, you know, we can hunt, don't get us wrong, but we like to chill, we like to be at peace, we like to hang out at the crib. But when you go into a cunning hunter, you know, you got Esau, Edom, you know, some of the top hunters. Who are they mostly hunting? You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Like, you've been hunted, so therefore it goes to show you that you do have an enemy. And then, as you can see in this picture, like, all of these, you know, from the beginning of the time, you know, the spirits of Jacob and Esau go back to Cain and Abel. Cain slew Abel. What are Esau, Edom trying to do nowadays? They're trying to slay Jacob. So there's nothing new under the sun. But, you know, going back to being a cunning hunter, like the top hunters, when you have the duck calls, you have, you know, Edomites who created the duck calls. You know, they camouflage themselves in leaves and in trees. You know, they'll put, you know, all kind of like deer, you know, urine or bear urine on them. So, you know, that can mask their smell and things like that. But they're cunning hunters. But at the end of the day, like I was saying, they're mostly hunting, you know, Jacob. And you're going to see that this devil is going to show his horns in these last days. You know, let me get that too. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 12 and verse 12. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a short time. So he's going to have great wrath upon you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, because he knows that his rulership is going to be cut short. Like, he thinks that this place is going to go on forever. But so he's going to bring forth great, great wrath, this devil, this deceiver. Let me grab that. It's the book of Psalms, chapter 49, verse 11. Their inward thought is, you know, Esau, Edom, that their houses shall continue forever, and their dwelling places to all generations. They call their lands after their own names. So they believe that their generations are going to be passed down forever and ever. And me and the brother, Brother Yagadah, we've been watching this this TV series called, you know, Foundation. And you have Edomites that pretty much have perfectly, so they say, cloning themselves, you know, to kind of pass down from generation to generation. You know, it just goes to show you the thought process of Esau, Edom. You know, they want their empire, you know, to last forever. You know, they passing on, you know, certain knowledge and so-called wisdom, you know, so that they can continue forever. And even today, they name their lands after their own names, which America goes into bitter, being bitter. You know, the word means bitter. But America is named after Amerigo Vespucci. You know, you have Africa named after Leo Scipio Africanus. Then I have a few more precepts that I wanted to bring out. Actually, this will be the last one. Psalms 55 and 21. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart. So they go around, you know, talking softly, like even with the weapons of mass destruction, which they were pretty much, you know, lying. They just wanted to go over to the so-called Middle East and declare war, you know, amongst those heathens, you know, to take their resources, because that's what they do. So they say, you know, smooth words like butter to get the people, you know, on their side. So you can't really see what they're really, what's really going on. But they have war in their heart, which your heart is your mind. His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords. So swords is pretty much a killing instrument. So that's, you know, as you see in this photo, all of these are pretty much killing instruments. Because the CBDC is going to ultimately lead into that microcharagma, which if you take that, you know, then you're pretty much going to end up dying, you know, whether it be from some type of cancer or something. But ultimately, the Most High, Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, is going to send you to the spirit world. But that's pretty much all that I had on this lesson. Lord willing, it was edifying. Kol Halayim La, Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, Bashem Rakakodash. Double honors to the elder apostles, the elders of Great Millstone. Peace and blessing to the Akim and a few Akwath across the four winds. Shalom, and the Baba Baal.